I'm Vincent Wittenberg. I'm a independent public space designer from Eindhoven.
I'm Cindy van den Bremen, social designer from Eindhoven.
And we are working together in a team on the project called Proefstation Beukelaan. We work together with two other designers, Barry Sanders, who is a graphic designer, and Ellen de Vries, who is a light architect. And we joined the competition Your Street with a project called Gloeilamp Pad.
It's actually a plantsoen, which is the Dutch word for park. Our main assignment was to improve the train station, which is on the other side. And it's a rather anonymous train station because there's not that many people taking the train. Also, it's above eye level, the high spoor, hoogspoor actually. And it's at an intersection of the ring through Eindhoven where cars pass by really quick. So you feel kind of lost as a biker, as a pedestrian or as a traveler. And what we did is we looked at all the areas surrounding the train station. So in the back there is a rather poor area of inhabitants. Here is a rather upcoming area, a creative area, Strijp S, with a lot of entrepreneurs and with different needs and demands as the inhabitants over there. What we try to do is emphasize the bridge function of the train station and to see if we can use the train station more as a bridge for those people to meet. And part of our concept is this gloeilampplantsoen.
The path structure in the park was originally designed as a light bulb, logically. And we noticed that people from the neighborhood go over here to walk their dogs. And this used to be in the Philips era, it used to be a beautiful park. There used to be a nice pond and flowers and now it's totally overgrown.
So what we wanted to do is to restore this area by opening up the entrance again. Trippelen, in Dutch, is the word for dribbling or walking by dogs. And it's a parody on the history of the area. Part of the reason why NS Beukelaan has such a bad reputation is the fact that in this street were the tippelaarsters, or the prostitutes, that were
street
allowed. Yeah, the street prostitutes that were allowed, gedoogd by the government. And in the evening, this street would be
a one-way street. So the cars would actually loop around the train station. And this attracted also dealers and,
unwanted guests. And so what we did instead of the tippelzone, which refers to the name of visiting the prostitutes, we made it the triple route.
So we're now in the light bulb park, and this is actually this round path is part of the bulb.
What was nice is what we did with Google Maps, we measured the old structure of the path, and we went with a big measuring tape to measure the distances to the street and to mark the path so that the machines could find it again and mow their way through the bushes.
So where we're standing now, you could actually not walk. So, and we didn't have good maps, so yeah, we had to do it with old aerial pictures and Google Maps.
We had minimum budget and minimum power. So we tried to find ways to make the path visible again, and we chose
wood chips as a material, so it will disappear after a while. Of course, we hope that people will walk the paths now and it will stay open. But since this area is also it's owned by a developer, this was a demand, and it also fits the character of this place. Some of the wood chips are made out of the branches that we cut here. We cut one big tree that was dead, so to prevent it from falling over on the people walking on the paths. And we used this part of the tree as seating in the park.
What we tried with this park is to stimulate and encourage people to walk around here and to come from other areas and cross the train station. And they form the eyes and the ears of the station to improve the safety and the identity of the area.
With a minimum impact on the park as it is now.
And with actually emphasizing the characteristics of the park, because we were really charmed by the nature itself
and the informal use of the public space.
And the rabbits and the mushrooms. I mean, it would be a great place to picnic. It would be wonderful if you can encourage something like that.